Hi there. Today is the first really sunny day since a few weeks. Before there was just a bit hint of some sunbeams, and now we have sunshine since 2 hours or so. So I thought I can take a video of a comparison of 30 poundage bows. So I've taken 4 of my collection that fit into this range. There's only one bow I have currently available. This is the 30 pound hound bow. That won't be in this comparison because I would like to compare to the hybrid bow that is created by Abu Salman and will be shipped the next days somewhere. So it will arrive maybe January or February, you never know. So this will be a later video then. For today, I have here the bear paw fiberglass bow. Should be a Mongolian style, but it looks more like something else, maybe Manchu or something. It's a modern interpretation of what the guys think that could be Mongolian, but it isn't. Yeah, so it's just named Mongolian. Then we have here the jigsaw by Saf. This is Egyptian style with more or less no zia. Then we have the Tang Dun Huang by Alibo, slightly asymmetrical with long zias. And then we have the Hanbo, last but not least, also asymmetrical by Grosser. And this is a biocomposite. So we have 2 laminated, 1 fiberglass and 1 biocomposite. All nominal strength 30 pound at 28 inches. The measurements. So I did that once, but that's so long ago. Here we measure quickly. It's a long bow. Long, 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 long. 58 inches from knock to knock. 58. So then stringing. So away with this. Sorry for the background noise. Some construction workers discovered as well that the weather is nice. So, this. Yeah, it's also a bit tricky thing. So, stringy is of course easy. Just a moment. So that's how the bow looks like, strung. And length, strung. So, short hands, 51. 51. Brace height? Yes, it has brace height of, I measure where the arrow would be, in this case would be the other way around. So here I can already see some scratches that I've done last year. So from here, 8.5, 8.5. So the limbs have a thickness of, I measure it in millimeters. It's 38 and thickness. This is covered in leather, so the leather, I can already see it here, has a thickness as well. So leather is not really working, so it's just the coverage. I need to subtract around 1 millimeter in total. This would be 8, so the working thickness is 7 mm. Yeah, 7 mm. So. Zia length. Moment of truth. this is, I'll show you here. Sorry. From here to there, 4, 4.5. Yeah, we can be generous, 4.5. So it's a very short, long zia. So, here, come auf oben. So, poundage should be 30. I have here an arrow. Here's a marking at 28 inches. So. And we have here scale. Now we'll see. Six. That's quite right. Very good. 36. Okay. That's the bear paw. The weight. Weight of the bow. $710. Okay, next one. The jigsaw. $51, unstrung. And strong. Easy to string. The triangular shape of the Egyptian style. Strung length. This forty-seven. Brace height is here. Eight and a half. Limbs thickness. It's 6.5 or 6.4. And the width, maximum width, is 37.4. Zias, zero weight, $450. So, poundage. So currently we have cold temperatures here, so there can always be a little difference. Now I have here 33.5. Maybe I took that bit too long, take another chance. 31.60. Now the Tanduan. Okay, that's a long Sias. Length, knock to knock. Is 62.5. Alibo doesn't recommend to do the step through method. Look away. So, this is the ball scrum. Length. It's long. Long. I'll try to get this. 57.5. Right side. Six and a half. The rim's width, maximum 39, and thickness 6.5. 6.5. Your length, long. It's hard to measure because the Sias are fading into the working limbs. So it's somewhere between 8.5, 9, around this. So this is still long, so around 9 inches. The weight. No, never. Okay. 440. And poundage. Check. $29.86. Give it another try. Maybe it was not enough. $30.40. Yeah, 30 is okay. Now the Hanbo. Length knock to knock. I wait until I pull, unless I have the feeling that the bow is right on between the legs, so that the feeling is correct here. Yeah. I don't want to twist the bow. This bit. Yeah. Okay, the hand bow. named Strum. Race height. Six and a half. So, and Lumps thickness. Is 7.7. And the width maximum is 39.3. Zia, different lengths. So the one has 9. And the other is 7. So they're both long zias. 9 and 7. The weight. Grams. Check. Yeah. 34.8. I'll give it another try. Yeah, let's take the average because I'm not really sure where the marking is. You can see here in the comparison. This bow is a little heavier, about 10% higher in the moment. Yeah, so this bow has just been strung, you have seen it. It's quite cold here. The air is dry, so this can have an effect. So, as you could hear, the measurements are quite different. The nominal poundage was always the same, and indeed we measured slightly differences in between. The bear paw and the Tang Dun Huan were quite on point on the poundage check today. Jigsaw was a bit higher, and the Han bow was about nearly 10% higher. The lowest weight has the Tang Dun Huan, and the heaviest bow weight wise is the bear paw with 710 grams. Regarding the limbs thickness, the maximum has the Han bow with a biocomposite, and I said it has horn on the one side, on the belly side. It's processed horn, yeah, so we all know the discussion. So there are, maybe it's horn powder whatsoever, it's in, and we have sinew on the back, and so the behavior is a bit different, and this bow reacts a little to environmental changes like the temperature or the humidity. So there is a difference. Yeah. So with a horn bow, this is typical, and with a biocomposite bow, this can happen too. The laminated bows are not that much affected by temperatures, and the fiberglass bows usually aren't, because fiberglass is not affected by humidity. Of course, you can melt it. Yeah, so if you throw it into the fire, the bowl will definitely change. Definitely. So regarding the length, knock to knock, the jigsaw, as you could have expected, is the smallest one. And the longest one is the Tang Dun Wang, which is clear. Yeah. Regarding the Zias, we have zero and a very short long, and the rest has long Zias. So that's more or less no Zia and long Zia. Regarding the brace height, we have two bows that have the same. So they are Bearpaw and Jigsaw, who have both 8.5 inches brace height. And the Han and the Tang Duan have the same brace height as well of 6.5. So they are comparable. And now the question is, how do they feel if you pull them? And that's what we find out now. Okay, I throw away these arrows. These are 600 spined Ox Pro by Niowa. They have currently 32 inches and a weight of 405 grain. Maybe I cut them down to 29.5, but this is something I need to test at other arrows so that the length is correct, because of this new aiming method that could maybe work for me. But before I cut down these arrows, I want to be sure that this method works for me. Okay, so check out Charlie Greenberg's channel, so that will be something you might find interesting. All right, so now let's shoot. Starting with the bear paw. So you hear the oscillation. This bow has a lot of vibration. Usually the Mongolians shouldn't be shot with katra. I'll do so, otherwise the vibration will be too strong. Right. Oh, so, tight knocking here. Center shot. Short distance at about 8 meters. It feels very easy. And the shot, yeah, nice, yeah, very easy. And the vibration is there, yeah, definitely. But with a cutter, you don't feel it that much. I can still feel it in the hand. Now it's gone. So it's quite a long time, so I show you the result. Yeah, so shooting result is okay. So this is bow. Yeah, guitar built in. Oh, that's fine. Yeah, no problem. So this bow is not expensive. Don't remember, it was 150 euro or so, 200, I don't know. So it's not much. Yeah, it's if you're on a budget, oh, that's fine. Yeah, it's okay. So now the jigsaw. The handle is a bit different. As you can see here, this is nicely rounded. And here is the pressure point for your palm. You hold it like this, and here, as you can see, the arrow passes by. Sound. Okay. Very nice and soft draw. show you the results.
Excuse me, I don't use these arrows for the bow.
Also need to aim a bit differently. So this bow feels very nice. So if you draw it, yeah, you can feel the tension. So there's, it's not a heavy bow regarding weight, and the performance is very nice. So you have the bending section quite clear, so the handle is not bending at all because there is epoxy in it. So this is stiff from here to there. The bending section is exactly this. So everything else is bending. See? And this is quite nice. It feels very good. And since there is nearly no weight here on the tips, you have, yeah, everything is working towards the target. So you have it here, very solid handle, and the rest is working for you and throws the arrow away. Dun Huang, with the rayskin leather protection I've put on, has a round handle. Feels very good. And yeah, it's quite long. It's made for long draw. And since I pull here nearly Turkish style, so close to that one, this draw is not so long. Yeah. So I won't max the bow out. So my personal absolutely maximum draw length is 31. And on the right side, I don't reach this 31. I reach it with the left side. All right. So again, the 8 meters. Very nice, smooth draw as well. So they all draw very nice and smoothly. And here I have more vibrations than in the jigsaw, but less than in the bear paw. Yeah, they are still. Yeah, and now it's gone. Again. Gone. Show you. So I'm aiming a bit high today. Maybe it should get lower. So this bow I've bought second hand. And yeah, this is the reason why it was a bit cheaper for me. This bow hasn't been shot much. And yeah, well, it's a long draw monster. So you can draw this to here. Yeah, and for the right side, due to my shoulder issues, I get to here. Yeah, so that's the reason why I cannot show you 30 inch draw. Not on that side, on the other side. Maybe I could do that. The handbow handle is usually very squarish, so the same style you can see here, and it's quite uncomfortable to deal with if you want to shoot it. So this is my modification I've done on this. Makes springing easier because you have more surface here you can lean against your leg. And so the pressure point is here as well, so it's widened up. That's now a big handle. Maybe a bit too big, but otherwise it would have been not enough to get rid of this these edges, so that I don't feel it anymore. Okay. We remember that due to the environmental temperature and humidity, the bow was a bit stronger. And I expect that I will feel it now in the draw. Although it's not that eye striking. or muscle striking. It feels still soft, although the scale says it's more. And the heavy arrows are precisely the correct arrows for this bow. The last one was a bad shot, but the other two were looking good. I can see the first two shots in the center, and the third one was a little off. So this bow has a lot of oscillation too. You can feel it in the handle a bit. Now gone. And nevertheless, the drawing is nice, shooting is nice too. And results are good too, with the heavy arrows. Okay. Doing now the same exercise with the Gao Ying style, and since I don't have the proper quivers here in the moment, and would be a mix anyway, I use my shoes. That's fashion. Okay. So. But the draw is nice, it feels very easy, but in the point of release, in this moment, I can feel the vibration in my shoulder. Okay, I'll show you. So this Mongolian or Manchu bow style. So this shooting, this way of shooting was not as good as the other style before. The jigsaw, we are at about 10 meters now. Works as well, although the style is not intended for this bow. Feels very nice, soft, a bit loud. The last one was a bad shot. The first two are closer to the center than the last one. With the Turkish style, I was a bit higher, and with the Gao Ying style, I'm now a bit lower. Okay, the Tang Dun Huang, 10 meters. Now I try to do the extended draw that I'm capable of. And this is nearly a center shot. It's a bit too right, to the right, not to the left. Yes, this is definitely what the bow is made for. The second is to the right and the other two are quite close to the center. And I haven't practiced this. So this is In the last week, I have practiced one skywing style and not with this bow. It was just trying to get the left side shooting a bit trained. I've done 15 shots because of didn't want to get too much pressure on the right shoulder. And as you can see, it's really working well with the Tang Dun Huang. So, and now the Hanbo. I don't know his max draw length in the moment, but we'll see. It's not much. So I could already feel that it's getting too strong. I think it was around 30 inches, maybe less. I think it's 30 inches. And last in a row. Results were good. So, maybe you can see here better. A bit to the left. However, the next draw is of course not as long as for the Tang Dun Huang, because it's not made for this. So the initial question was, do I feel a difference in the bows, yeah, of different shapes, but same poundage? And in this case, not really. And I think this is because of the similar bending lengths. So every bow has a bending section and rigid sections. And in this case, the bending section is from here to there. And this is about, here's the transition area. I think this is now, let's say, 19 inches. Yeah, so I show you here. Yeah, it goes up to here. So this is the bending section, 19 inches. Bending section here is, I get the right angle. So from here, not good. 20 inches. Yeah, so it's just 1 inch difference. Show you again. Yeah, the whole limb is working. Here, the upper section. So, 19 inches, because this was the transition area from here to there. The lower is from here to 19 inches as well. So it's exactly the same as for the bear paw. The Han look at the bending section and we see that it starts approximately here. So, this is about 16. And the lower one, 12. So indeed the Hanbo has the shortest bending length, and that's the reason why it feels stronger up to this point. Yeah? So that's eye striking. And we measured 10% more poundage before, and it feels heavier as well because of the bending section that is kicking in already here. Yeah, and if you overcome this, this is, yeah, you can feel it. Nevertheless, the bow feels very soft. All these bows have the same bending length. Yeah, so this is the reason why they feel very similar. If the Tang Dun Huang, which is a very nice B-shaped one, the D-shaped one Jigsaw, or the Bear Paw, they all feel similar in raw because of the bending length. So, yeah, what's the favorite bow? This is really hard to say. So, two of these four bows have been made to my order. There is first the Jigsaw. So, Jigsaw is usually the name of this bow because it has grooves for the fingers. But this is then if you shoot left or right hand sided. I shoot both sided, and so I do not have this pattern. And yeah, nevertheless, this is the Jigsaw shape. And this bow is very special to me because Zaf has created it for me, and there's a lot of soul in there. So, in this case, although I'm quite sensitive to sound, I like the sound. Yeah, so this is a soul bow for me. This is very special. So even if I cannot draw this bow to 31 inches, because the max draw of this bow is 30, I will never max out this bow, because I do not shoot it the Gaoying style. Yeah, I will shoot it the Turkish style so that the bow cannot be harmed. And yeah, I like to shoot him because he's a very precise shooter. Usually I have a little yeah, lighter arrows with him, and so I'm quite precise on this one. So I like this bow very much. Yeah, just to mention this. And then the next that has been made to my order is the Han bow. So I've waited for this Han bow long, really long. And so I was very happy when he came. I like the biocomposite style a lot, so I'm a fangirl of this style, and these biocomposite bows are very easy to handle. You string them and then you go out and shoot. You can't do this with a real horn bow. Yeah, you need to string the horn bow, wait for half an hour or longer, and then you can shoot him slowly. So this is a bit tricky, and you need to adjust the bow just when you have strung it, and you do not need to do this much exercise with the biocomposite. If you have strung it, you make sure that the tiller is fine and this is all in a good shape and that the bow is straight, and then it's good, you're good to go. And yeah, what you can feel and measure is that the bow can get a bit heavier if the humidity is dry, so in winter time. Then you can measure up to 10% more strength. At least I could do it. Yeah, today I could do it, and last year when I had the Mongolian biocomposite, I measured as well that the bow was not 40 pound but 43 pound. And I couldn't handle this bow. That was the reason why I gave it then to Armin Hirmer. And yeah, nevertheless, I like the style of these bows, and especially this Hanbow feels easy to draw, nevertheless. So it feels so easy that I thought, 30 pounds, it's nothing, nothing. But then on the Paderbow fair a few weeks ago, I pulled a 30 pound bow, horn bow, that was much shorter, and it was much harder. So there is something, according to the bending length of the bow, that makes a bow to be drawn easier or heavier. And this is quite something I try to figure out what the reason is, and I have already an idea, but I want to be sure on that before I do a video about it. So next, so as well, a very nice bow, smooth draw and everything. You only need to make sure that you get along with the handle. And I guess most people are doing modifications like this on their Hanbow, if they got it. Otherwise, it's quite uncomfortable to shoot. But with this modification, it's good. Then, next nice bow is the Tang Dunhuang. I'm really happy that I've bought this bow. The handle is very nice. There are no edges, feels soft, round, very good. It's slightly asymmetric as well. Shooting is nice, the draw is excellent, and this bow is made for long draw. Really good. And as you could see in the video, it's easy, really easy, even for me, to draw this bow to whatsoever. So the max draw of this bow is, if not mistaken, 35 inches. This is quite long. And yeah, of course, I don't feel any stacking here. The bear paw. Yeah, this bow I've bought just because I couldn't wait for another 1 year ago. This was then a present to Christmas from my husband. And yeah, it's a nice looking bow, but compared to the others, it's a fiberglass bow. And yeah, it's heavier, it's more vibrating. It's easy to shoot. Yeah, you could see the results are good. But if you have the others, then you would always go for the others first. And this is a bit unfair because it's a good bow. Yeah, there's nothing I could complain about. The only thing that is that you have your additional mass on the tips, which are not necessary. But yeah, that's how the design looks like. And this makes it a bit more tricky if you want to get these loops that curl themselves, if you want to get them over this. This was the point when I was stringing this bow in the beginning, where I struggled a bit to get this curled loop over this tip. And yeah, it's nicely built. You have here the string groove. It's all fine. Yeah, the leather feels nice. Yeah, so it's a good bow. So if you want to have a bow quickly, you can go for this. Yeah, it's no problem. And results are fine. But indeed, this is not a Mongolian style, even if Bearpaw says so. Yeah. I've misspoken myself before in a video. The Manchu bows are not drawn with Katra. Mongolian bows are, but this is not the Mongolian bows, it's something in between. So yes, you can do this. You can draw this bow with Katra. Yeah, nobody will bash you if you do so. And anyway, yeah, you can draw your bow the way you want. No problem. don't let anybody tell you something different. Yeah, they, you can always get tips how to improve your style, but if you're good on what you're doing and you hit the target, then this is your style. Point. Okay. Yeah, hard to say which one's my favorite. So anytime when I'm asked which bow is your favorite, I say all. It's really hard to say. And every bow has its benefits, its pros and cons. And in the end, it's just what you feel. And if you enjoy shooting a bow, then the bow is perfect. And if you enjoy shooting another bow as well, then the other bow is perfect too. Yeah, so there is not the bow. There are these bows. Thank you every bowyer for building the bows for us. And yeah, wish everybody a nice week. Enjoy archery and keep up the fun. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.